Okay, so you have this amazing new skill, and you can calculate all sorts of motion problems. Now, can you calculate every motion problem? And the answer is not quite yet. There are two types of problems we still can't solve. We can't solve problems where an object starts with some initial velocity, and we can't solve problems where the object moves in two dimensions, but we'll get to that later. For now, let's talk about this initial velocity idea. The variable we're going to use to talk about initial velocity is v with this subscript 0. This comes from the idea that when we start a problem, we usually start our timer at 0. And so this is at time equals 0. What is the velocity? So let's think back to Galileo standing on top of the Leaning Tower of Pisa. This time around, instead of just having him drop the ball, let's imagine he could throw the ball straight down with different initial velocities. Now, just to get you thinking, I want to think about this question: when will the ball go farther? So if he drops the ball with an initial speed of 0, so that's truly just dropping the ball, not throwing it at all, will the ball go further then? Let's say in a single second? Or will the ball go farther if he throws it at 10 meters per second straight down? So in 1 second, when will the ball go farther?